it's day five of TIFF, and I don't know if you can tell, but I'm quite getting in the swing of things now. TIFF is, it's sort of my new God. One film that loves to talk about God is Cloud Atlas. And I should warn you, I take this next review when I was still a man.
That's it. The music from my dream.
There are whole movements I wrote imagining us meeting again and again in different lives, in different ages.
I can't explain it, but I knew when I opened that door,
a powerful deja vu ran through my bones.
Suspend that disbelief right up in the clouds. Let's take it for granted that Tom Hanks can pass as a boozy Irish novelist and Halle Berry as a white Jewish aristocrat. Tom, Tykwer and the Wachowskis demand that you take their adaptation of David Mitchell's novel seriously.
Yesterday, my life was headed in one direction. Today, it is headed in another.
You ever think the universe is against you?
Fear. Belief, love, phenomena that determine the course of our lives.
The six stories of the book have been chopped to bits, so the action swings from a 19th century Pacific voyage to a far-off future where it's cool to wear a polo on your head. There's enough in Cloud Atlas that you'll find something to love. Just don't, whatever you do, think about it too hard.
We are bound to others, past and present. And by each crime, every kindness, we birth our future.
So as the old saying goes, every cloud has a silver lining, and every silver lining has a playbook. Still a man.
What meds are you on?
Me? None. I used to be on lithium and Seroquel and Abilify, but I don't take them anymore, no. They make me foggy and they also make me bloated.
Yeah, I was on Xanax and Effexor, but I agree, it wasn't as sharp, so I stopped.
You ever take Klonopin?
Klonopin, yeah.
Right?
Jesus.
Like, is it what?
Yeah.
What day is it? How about Trazodone?
Trazodone?
Well, it flattens you out. I mean, you are done. It takes the light right out of your eye.
God, I bet it does.
The funny thing about mental illness is, well, nothing really, but don't let that stop you enjoying David O. Russell's romantic comedy. It's about two damaged people learning to fix each other through a love of football, dance, and being horribly inappropriate. Bradley Cooper and Jennifer Lawrence play our blunt and brutal heroes. Julia Stiles and John Ortez are on hand as their long-suffering mates. You wouldn't prescribe Silver Linings Playbook to anyone who couldn't be cured by a dose of odd couple comedy. But of itself, it's a cheerful, therapeutic watch.
You say more inappropriate things than appropriate things. You scare people.
I tell the truth, but you're mean.
What, I'm not telling the truth?
Maybe I should drive them home separately?
No, you can drive them both home now.
Now, 2 years ago, The King's Speech premiered here. It went on to win the Audience Award and then it cleaned up at the Oscars. This year, we've got the sequel, King's Speech 2, American Adventure.
No King of England had ever visited America before.
So nice of you to come, Mr. President. Forgive me for not getting up.
So Franklin invited them here, to the country, where we could all relax.
Bertie's back in this 1939 set drama about the personal travails of a disabled leader. But the focus this time round is not on George VI and the Queen Mum, but on Franklin D. Roosevelt and Daisy, his fifth cousin and umpteenth mistress. The President invites the King for a summit at his mother's country retreat so they can have a powwow ahead of the war.
She's obviously his mistress. Look over there.
The secretary.
They'll see us.
Wave.
I am.
The two men bonded famously and shared stories about how to cope with being the main man and what a pain wives can be. Roger Michell's film is the classiest mockbuster you'll ever see. It opens out a radio play for the big screen, and yet it still feels like a big slab of masterpiece theatre.
I thought I might have a swim. Come along.
I made them all agree. No pictures in our bathing suits.
Now, North Americans do seem to have a bit of a penchant for posh old Brits. Exhibit B, quartet.
Fancy for a little rumpy pump, is this one?
Qu'est-ce que c'est, rumpy pump?
Quartet is Dustin Hoffman's loving tribute to the elderly thesps of his adopted country. Maggie Smith, Tom Courtney, Billy Connolly, Pauline Collins, Trevor Peacock and Michael Gambon are all holed up in a Downton-esque retirement home for classical musicians. Does that sound like your idea of a living hell? Well, quartet might not be for you. But the audience at the Ryerson Theatre the other night whooped and bawled, cackled and wept. Hoffman's masterstroke seems to be in marrying a campy old English comedy with a high school drama in which the prom king and queen are reunited and everyone comes together to put on a show. It won't be music to everyone's ears, but it's hard to stop a foot from tapping.
This place is a godsend. It's a blessing.
The festival rolls on. There's plenty more films still to see. I'm off to get me a TIFF tattoo. Join us tomorrow for more from the Toronto International Film Festival, aka God.